welcome back to the walkthrough. In this part, we ended up on the egg carriers. In the last part, we ended up on the egg carrier. So it's time to continue with the cutscene. Oh, do you remember this particular scene on the deck? I think you might, and now we're about to see the other side of it. Oh my goodness, don't get out the claw. Anything but the claw. Sonic, save me!
Sonic, help!
I said that first. Don't steal my line. Well, you said it differently, but still. Oh my god, the claw game! No! It just stole my 50 cents! I can never grab a stuffed animal from those things, and Eggman just grabs one like that. What the poop? He must be the master of claw games or something like that. And it's a live animal, too, not a plush one. And it appeared to be holding a Chaos Emerald! So, yeah, in case you don't realize, this is how you meet up with Sonic and Tails on the egg carrier, and as well as Eggman popping in at the same time. Oh, poop! Yeah, you better run! Wait, Mr. Robot? She said Sonic before in the other cutscenes. What the... Huh? Oh, looks like Sonic already damaged him. Poor E-102 Gamma.
Amy? That's one of Eggman's clunkers. Out of my way.
What?
No.
Eggman didn't go to the bathroom there. What are you talking about, Sonic?
This robot is different. You don't need to hurt him, okay?
Amy. Okay, I guess I'll let him go then.
Oh my god! The ship is breaking apart for seemingly no reason again. Unless that was when Sonic went through the sky back and he aimed the cannons to blow itself up or something. I don't know. It sure seemed like it was flying well when he came out of the sky back that one time, don't you think? Huh. These plot holes I have to point out all the time. Dang it. Well, anyway, this is where we part ways. And I fly down with Tails. If I'm not mistaken. Hey, stop humping my back! Oh, thank you. I'm with Amy on that one. His pay is horrible. And with this economy, you just... Oh! Go, Tails! Go! Take Amy off the plane! Yes! Quit from Eggman's job! You can get a better job somewhere else! Come, E-102 Gamma! You can fly away! Sorry, I just had to watch the cutscene again. I was trying to finish the joke, and I just got ruined by the beauty of that cutscene. So screw the joke. I just wanted to watch the cutscene. Loading screen just ruined it all once again. And I guess we're flying back to Station Square. I can see myself coming in for a landing in the sky. Oh! And we're safe. That was quite the flight. Hey, where are you going? There was no dialogue between the two. You're supposed to say at least see you later or goodbye or something before you depart.
He's always messing me, please.
Ever since Sonic CD. Well, that explains why they are after you. Oh, I just said that, dang it. Oh.
Hey, a peasant. Where
Isn't that cute? It looks like a little birdie family. Oh, poof. I hope not. He probably transformed them into robots like he does all living creatures, except himself. That, in my opinion, is hypocritical of Eggman. Ugh. To the Mystic Ruins we go! So, yeah, we just gotta take the train over to that forest area, you know, where the minecart is. Next to the lake. Yeah, take that minecart into the forest and... Whoa, it's nighttime! Spooky! I believe this is going to be the first time we're going to see the forest at nighttime, too. So that's going to be pretty cool. Woo! I'm flying with hearts all over the place with love of this area. The camera should hold up against it better, too, because it's a naturally dark area, and then it should, just flop down here, and... No, it's still not holding up well against it. Well, it's only making Amy glow, kind of. And it actually seems kind of like the frame rate's kind of slow or something, I don't know. That could be the screen that I'm looking at, you know, the little LCD screen on the camera. I don't pay much attention to it most of the time, but I glance back on it. On occasion. Whee! So, yeah, we're just trying to find Eggman's base, and there is the Lost World. Eggman's base is always right behind it, and this statue seemingly is transforming itself. Did you see that? What the poop was that? I have no idea, and it seems to do that for no reason. I have no idea why it does that, really. It doesn't seem to be an indication of anything other than the fact that you're nearby, but there doesn't seem to be any real reason behind that happening. Like, it has nothing to do with the story, to my knowledge. You weren't even in the forest before, Amy. What are you talking about? How do you know there... Were you here in the forest and it was off-camera or something? No, I was here the entire story. You never went in the woods, so how would you know that there wasn't a bridge here before? Anyway, into the door, and I don't know why they flipped the camera around that way. It was like the worst way they could. So anyway, there is someone, I believe it was CJV94US, or 95US, excuse me if I got your name wrong there, that said that isn't Mega Sonic, it's Silver Sonic. So my bad there, but they do have different Sonic models. Like, you'll notice there's a model of Sonic that looks like that, a robotic Sonic that looks like that. And then there's the other one that you see over here. Now, this one looks closer to the Silver Sonic model from Sonic the Hedgehog 2, doesn't it? I just thought I'd point that out there, because there appears to be a bunch of Sonic prototypes robots around here. Anyway, you remember this door puzzle right here. Yeah, all you have to do is turn all these Eggman heads into yellow, and there you go. I believe I'm gonna get it first try. Yeah, well, technically it's not the first try. There's probably like a minimal amount of rooms that you can do. Well, I guess it was the first try because I didn't reset the room or anything like that. This is stage 3, the last stage, final egg. Oh, poopers, why are you still following me? You got the freaking emerald. There's no need for this. This is completely uncalled for. Anyway, let's go! And jump over those lasers with your hammer if you can. Run around the spiky balls. There's no way you're going to be able to just run right through them at your ultra-slow speed. Look out for the claws of death. And flip yourself over here with your hammer. I find that's a lot easier to do than to just jump over the wall. But that's just my opinion on how to get through it the best way. You might feel more comfortable just jumping right between the bars. I know that he's all... Ah! His eyes closing in on me! Run for it! Oh, I should have did the hammer jump. Boopers, scoopers. And it's, I believe, a little puzzle... No, not a puzzle. No, I'm thinking of a different area. Excuse me. I'll cover it when it gets there. Okay, press this switch. Wait for the elevator to come down. Hide somewhere, because the robot is coming. Woo! And look out. Oh my goodness, he's gonna throw his arms. Yeah, this is the best way to divert him, is just to just go on the other side of it. And once the elevator comes down, go inside it, and he'll try to get you up there, but he'll fall to his doom. Aw, poor robot. I don't know why I even feel sorry for you. You've tried to kill me numerous times, and I haven't done anything to you! Stop following me! Whoops, I failed on the hammer jump. By the way, if you pick up that barrel and go inside it, you can hide from the robot and he'll disappear for a while. Unless he notices that you went inside the barrel. But I just don't even bother with the barrels. Not this part. This thing is purely luck-based. You have to pick a door and hope it's the right one. I believe it's randomized. So I'm just going to try this one with three lights at the top and see if it goes. I mean, see if it works out. Crap, it's a trap and the robot's on my heels. I'm going to go into door one quickly. Must find the right door. This thing has got to be like the most annoying thing to time trial ever. I mean, because it's luck-based and you don't know which door it is, you have to find the right door the first time. Otherwise, it would pretty much screw up your perfect run through the stage if you had one. And I hate when you speedrun stages like that. You can easily get up on top of here without using the barrel, just by using your hammer. Stop that. Let me hammer you, thank you. and there's the balloon, and that's the end of the stage. Yeah, all right. Yeah, normally when you climb up on that ledge that I showed you before that I said you need the barrel for, you need to bring the barrel over to that ledge and then climb up on top of the barrel by jumping on it and then go up to the ledge. But it's much, much faster to just hammer jump up there. Loading. Indeedy. Looks like I'm in some sort of engine room or something. There appears to be some turbines underneath. Those holes look pretty big. Why don't my feet fall right through them, right? Anyway.
So maybe your family's still in there. Let's investigate,
what? I do! Actually, I kind of like you, Birdie. I don't want to get rid of you. I don't want you to go back to your family. I like you as a companion. Alright. Oh, I just noticed we're kind of low on time on this part. So I'll see you in the next part.